right. She had her gallbladder out.
Well, the doctor told her she'd eat whatever she wanted.
I know, but still, there's certain foods that will trigger.
Yeah. Well, she had problems like that beforehand, too, so it's... She loves bean soup. And
yeah.
Well, good morning. I'm not doing much better. Good morning, everybody.
Morning.
How are we this morning? We made it back. Safely. That's good. The reason we're running a little late, I was on the phone with Don's daughter. I got the visitation and the funeral arrangements. The funeral is going to be in Glasgow, Missouri, which is where he's from.
Glasgow.
It's east of Marshall on the river.
Yep.
Be next Sunday. Visitation from 3 to 4 and the funeral's from 4 to 5. And I got the address of the cemetery. They don't want flowers. If we want to make contributions, they want contributions to go to Camp Valley. Don himself wasn't in the military, but his dad was. His son. That's where she would like contributions to go. Or both his daughters.
What happened? He passed away.
He passed away Wednesday at 9:14, I think is what she said. I was there Wednesday afternoon about 2:30. I went to see Cindy. She was on one side and Don was on the other side. John Knox. I went to see him the Thursday before. He was doing okay. But he couldn't walk. They sent him home from the rehab place in Pleasant Hill Friday morning, and used the lift chair. Called an ambulance and sent him back to the hospital. They finally did a CT scan, and his body was nothing but cancer. It had gone everywhere. And at that point, the doctors told him, there's not much we can do. And I think at that point, he was ready to go. So. When I went to see him, he'd been in a coma or whatever you want to call it.
Unresponsive
for about a day at that point.
He probably came back for a little bit right before he passed.
Yeah, I don't. That's usually what happens.
So what's the address of the...
The address of this place is 112 Market Street, Glasgow, Missouri. Unfortunately, yeah. We'll definitely be praying for him.
Yes.
And you.
And you. And Doug. Today, 12:30, we have a meeting and a lunch. Come on back.
The meeting's going to be fly by the seat of my britches. Probably need to discuss.
Bible study. You're back for Bible study. We did Bible study last week. Tamara did a pretty good job, I think.
Pretty cool.
More color me. site in the, what are, chapter three?
Yep, the third prayer.
The third prayer. 2 weeks is communion.
May's here in 2 weeks.
May's here in 2 weeks, yes.
Oh my.
Another
Lord.
Month, it's out the window.
Yeah, they're also calling for snow on Tuesday.
So. And they're calling for snow on Tuesday, yeah.
This Tuesday coming up?
Yeah.
Yes.
1 to 3 inches.
Seriously.
Yes.
With a...
Yeah.
You've got to stay on the highways.
With the highest...
Yeah, it
45.
Won't.
You
should have stayed in Texas.
It won't last. Jan received a card. You guys won't know Michelle Kelly. Michelle sent an announcement to Dan. She graduates June 18th. It's crazy.
It don't seem possible.
No, it don't seem possible. We're getting old.
No, no, no. I'm
no, no, no.
Already there.
You asked about shirts,
yeah.
Ruth. This one, and I don't know where it was sitting, I found it, but we would need to know by Wednesday to order this one. This one we've got a few weeks. Back to about 2 weeks. I'm going to pass them around. I kind of like the one that's due this week.
With my no.
any other announcements? Anything? Any words of wisdom?
Have none.
Have none?
Have none.
Well, if there's not, most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart, and we have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen. Let's open with our oh, you got where are they? Down below.
In the back.
She left her eyes here, so she has some. Let's start with our praise song, He Lives.
Today I know that he is living. Where
believe that he is coming back again. You may be seated. Our old And he reigned in Jerusalem 31 years. He did what was right in the eyes of the Lord and followed the ways of his father David, not turning aside to the right or the left. In the 8th year of his reign, while he was still young, he began to seek God, the Father, of his father David. In his 12th year, he began to purge Judah and Jerusalem of high places, Asherah poles, and idols. Amen. Lincoln Clinton. Accept these gifts, bless these gifts, and multiply these gifts so that we can go out and teach about you and your son. And it's in his name we pray. Amen. All right. Coming up. Props. Gotta have props. Okay. So what do we got here?
A lamp.
Okay. Let's see. It's not working. It's not very bright, is it?
Because it's not plugged in.
Oh, it's not plugged in. It needs electricity. Jesus told us to let our light shine. Did you know that? Jesus told people that if we let our light shine before men, that they will see our good works and glorify our Father which is in heaven. So what he's saying is there is we're not to hide our light, are we? We're supposed to let it shine out. Should we do it all the time or just sometimes? All the time. We should shine our light all the time. Now, it's pretty easy to turn the lights on, is it, nowadays? If it's plugged in, all you do is flip a switch, right? And the lights come on. Okay. But in Jesus' time, it was a little harder. They had to make sure they had the lamp, and they had to make sure they had oil, and they had to make sure that they had some fire to light it with. So it was a little harder to let their light shine. So they didn't do it as much. But we can do it all the time, can't we? How can you let the light that's inside you shine? Because?
Yeah.
Oh, be kind. That's right. Grandpa's getting old.
Turn up those hearing aids.
I'm gonna have to get hearing aids. That's right. You gotta be kind. That is a very good way to let your light shine. So when you see something happening to somebody else, you also need to help them, don't
stand
you?
Stand up.
Stand up. Stand up for them. That's right. You're doing really good, Hugh.
I see a future preacher.
I see. Yeah. You should have seen him back there singing.
I did.
Oh yeah, you turned that. He was out there and he was singing and.
Done a great
job. It was so neat to hear his voice.
It is.
Song.
You make everybody happy when you let your light shine. Here's the thing. We all let our light shine in church, don't we? But do we let our light shine when we're in school? Sometimes, huh? But see, you need to take that.
He literally just made the music teacher.
You need to stand up for that teacher. And let your light shine, not get mad at the person who did it. But just stand up and tell them that, you know, tell them what the teacher is doing is helping you. And, you know, stand up and tell them what they were doing was wrong. The fighting part is not good. But the standing up for them and helping them and being kind to them, that's where your light shines. Okay.
And that's extremely difficult to do.
It is very difficult to do. But we need to make sure we do it not only here in church, but that we do it at school or at Walmart. You are getting, your light's getting brighter every day, I know that, isn't it? Let's pray. Lord, help us to let our light shine all the time. Not just the times we think that it's best. And please help us to let our light shine so that others will know that we are your children and that we want to glorify you. And it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right. Get your treat. All right, while we're doing that, let's all turn to hymn number 280 and sing All Glory, Laud, and Honor.
I ain't really sure.
It's an old passion word.
Thank you.
Reading comes from the second letter to Timothy, chapter 3, verse 16. All scripture is God-breathed and is useful for teaching, rebuking, correcting, and training. Want to share this morning? All right. Well, over the last few weeks, 8 weeks? I don't know how long it was. Anyway, I talked about the 10 things we shouldn't believe and the 10 things we should believe to be Christians, about the book from The Least We Need to Know to Be a Christian. Well, it got me thinking. And so for the next 3 weeks, I'm going to talk about John Wesley's general rules. John Wesley, the founder of Methodism, came up with 3 general rules. And they are: do no harm, do good, and stay in love with God. Sounds easy, doesn't it? Yeah.
We do.
All the time. Without even thinking about it. Our reading today, our gospel reading, comes from Matthew chapter 5, verse 16. In the same way, let your light shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your Father in heaven. May God add his blessings to the reading of his word. So who here actually intends to hurt somebody? Yeah, put your hand there. We don't actually intend to hurt anybody, do we? In doing this, I about unintended consequences. She says they were moving into their new home, and they found that the steps to the basement weren't quite right. They weren't built to local standards. The house was rather old. The steps were actually shorter than they should be. And then there was a turn, and the turn even got shorter than the steps. And she says, and then there's a spot where if you're over 6 feet tall, you better duck, or you're going to hit your head as you're going down the stairs. Now, the builder didn't intend to do any harm, but through his actions in building these stairs, he actually did cause some harm, because as she said, there were several times her husband forgot to duck as he was going down the stairs. You would think after the first or second time you'd remember that. The Book of Discipline states that John Wesley expected all who continue that they should continue to evidence their desire of salvation to do no harm by avoiding evil of every kind, especially which is most generally practiced. And he gives this list of things. And the first one is, take the Lord's name in vain. We do it. From time to time, we stub our toe, or, you know, we don't intend to do that, but we do. Or profaning the day of the Lord by work or buying or selling. How many people, as soon as they leave church, go to Walmart, go to Kohl's, go shopping? We all do it. And because of that, how many businesses are open on Sundays now? Or, huh? Too many. Yeah. Drunkenness or buying and selling of spirits, unless in extreme cases. Go to the football game. Tailgate. For the Chiefs game. Then go in the game and drink. Or what we got coming up, Memorial Weekend. We don't. I don't do it anymore. When I was younger, I drank to excess. Fighting or quarreling, returning evil for evil. Now, I don't know how many here actually fight people. But we argue, don't we? It causes harm, doesn't it? And he goes on and on. He has a whole list of things on there. But how often do we do these things without even thinking about it? How often on Sundays, like I said, do we leave church and go shopping? Or this past year, a worldwide pandemic, a major illness, what they said, I think this morning they said 5 million worldwide have died. According to John Wesley and the Bible, we are directed to do no harm, aren't we not? But aren't we also directed to make sure that no one else is harmed? I'm not a fan of the mask. I'm sure you all probably know that I'm not a fan of the mask. When I get to a restaurant, I'm in a hurry to get to a table so I can take it off. But you know what? If I'm tasked to do no harm, am I not also tasked to wear a mask? Whether I like it or not, to keep others from getting sick, to keep others from having harm. It's a little inconvenience on my part, but it may save somebody from getting sick. I mean, I look back at Samantha. She tested positive but had no symptoms. A lot of people, you know, you hear about all the people that got sick and went to the hospital. How many people were actually positive and didn't even know it? We don't know. But if we were wearing masks, Ruth is very good about this. But if we were doing that, then we are doing our part in not doing harm to others. Reuben Job is the one who actually wrote the book called Three Simple Rules. And he does say that the first rule he said this. He says, if followed, not only do we do no harm to others, but we do no harm to ourselves. So if I'm wearing a mask, I'm not doing harm to others, but I'm also not allowing, I guess you could say, harm to be done to me. But he says this. He says, it often saves me from uttering a wrong word or considering a wrong response. This rule can provide a safe place to stand while the hard and faithful work of discernment is done. What is discernment? It's the ability to judge well, or perception in the absence of judgment, with a view of obtaining spiritual guidance and understanding. Discernment is not putting your foot in your mouth. I do it a lot. I put my foot in my mouth quite often, I think. And that can harm others, but it can also harm ourselves. It can harm our relationships with those people. So what is doing harm? Think about it this way. When you turned 16, you wanted your driver's license, right? So what did you do? You studied the rules, you studied the laws, and you took a test because you didn't want to do harm. Well, at 16, maybe you didn't think about that, but
you wanted the license.
Yeah. So you took the test and passed the test that said you understood the rules, you understood the laws, and that you would follow the rules and the laws. God did the same thing for us, didn't he? He gave us rules to follow. Do we intentionally break these commandments? No. We don't intentionally do it. We do not go out and kill or steal. But we might bend some of these that we don't think are quite as important. I mean, thou shalt not kill is pretty important. But what about thou shalt not covet anything that is thy neighbor's? I tell you this all the time. I'm going down the road, I see a nice-looking Camaro or a nice-looking Harley. I want it. Isn't that coveting something of somebody else's? Yeah, I know, that's one of those. But do we do it? We do that without even thinking about it. Now, in that instance, it's not really. Something. It's not ours. Take a pen from work. Take a pen from, you know. It's really not doing us any harm, but it's costing that business money because they got to buy more pens, don't they? But why did God give us these commandments? Because we have a tendency to do harm. It's in our sinful nature to do harm to other people's. It's not intentional most of the time. But we will say or do things that harms other people's. So how do we stop harming? We need to identify that we are doing it. We need to understand that we are causing harm. That our actions are doing harm to another person. And it doesn't necessarily have to be a person. It can be an animal. It can be the environment. It can be anything that God created. That God gave us the task of taking care of. If we're not taking care of it, are we doing harm to it? Are we not violating God's first rule when he created Adam and Eve and all the animals to have dominion and take care of the animals and take care of the world? We're violating that very first directive from God when we're not taking care of those things. Paul kind of dealt with the same thing with the Church of Rome. In Romans 14:15, he writes, "If your brother or sister is distressed because of what you eat, you are no longer acting in love. Do not by your eating destroy someone for whom Christ died." Peter had the same thing. Peter was following the Jewish laws. You can only eat certain things. But Peter was teaching to the Gentiles who pretty much ate what they wanted. Remember the dream he had with the sheep floating down and all the different animals and everything on it? God was telling him that it's okay to eat other things. It's okay because what they do, or you're eating to them. Not intentionally, because you're following what you think are the right rules, but we got to think of the other person. How about when someone does something to us, wrongs us? What's the perfect example of do no harm? Martin Luther King Jr. This is what first thing I thought of. Here's a man who was beaten, arrested. They did about everything to him. And what was his response? Peace. Peaceful protest. He did not do evil for evil. Jesus told us, love your neighbor as yourself. He told us to turn the other cheek. He told us a lot of things to do no harm to others. So try to be mindful this week of this concept. Pay attention to what you say. Pay attention to what you're doing. If someone does something to you, don't retaliate evil for evil. We don't intentionally do harm, but this is the toughest one because of what we unintentionally do. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we struggle in our daily lives to live up to you. We do not intend to harm others, but our actions seem to do just that. To see our hearts and keep us on the right path, that path to do no harm. The path to recognize when we do harm so that we can understand and work to fix it. Lord, we pray that we can follow your commandments in thought, word, and deed, and that eventually we can do no harm without thinking. That doing no harm becomes a way of life. Who lived and died so that we may live and have no fear of death. Amen. Let's turn to hymn number 399, Take My Life and Let It Be.
Matthew's family.
Cindy.
Yeah.
Although she's back to her old self thing as far as
mouth.
Dad has a red spot, potential new sore on his stump. Need prayers for healing.
The joy of family. I was able to go and babysit my grandbabies yesterday. That was fun and joyful. And my sister Alice, who lives in Maine, is going to come visit for a week, and she's not been able to be at the graveside or anything like that. So it will be nice to see her. I haven't seen her in 2 years.
Oh, so. Yeah.
That will be nice.
2 years is a long time.
It's a very long time.
Debbie?
My daughter, Sheree, and so I'd like prayers that she'll be able to find the right job, and she won't actually be able to graduate because of COVID, but she'll be done with school.
They're not holding up?
In person, yeah.
Okay.
They're holding a little one, but they had to say who would be okay with not coming.
Yeah, UCM has a very large graduating class. So.
Yes.
Yeah. She seemed very positive that everything was going well.
Yeah.
That's
I'm good. Just a worried mom.
Oh, moms do that.
Everyone taking the detour on 2 9. There's so many accidents on that road, and so many people get killed. It's
didn't know there were detours on 7.
No, 291.
Oh, 291.
To Harrisonville.
Okay.
Up the city.
Winnebago's bridge.
Winnebago bridge.
Good thing we didn't take that one then, huh?
Teresa told me there were 2 accidents in Holden the other morning. A rollover and a head-on. From what I hear, there were no serious injuries. It was in town, so the speeds were not good. Take those laws and rules. And yes, and that construction out in town is just
nightmare.
People crazy. All right, let's bow our heads for some silent prayer. Most Holy God, we are people who need you in our daily lives, fully in our lives. Our lives have complications and pains. Our world is war and despair. But Father, we were made in your image, and your spirit was breathed into us. Lord, we come across situations that sometimes make it hard for us to do no harm. And we pray for those whose lives are affected by our circumstances and our negativity at times and our unintended consequences. Lord, we pray for all the people in the world as they get vaccinated, and especially now that restrictions are starting to be eased, be with them. Remind them to do no harm. Lord, be with the politicians throughout the world, in our country, that they remember to do your will and not fight over petty issues, not bicker and quarrel. Lord, we ask that you be with Don's family as they remember a wonderful man. Remind them that he is with you. He's with his wife. He's no longer in pain. And remind them of all the wonderful memories that we have. Lord, be with Matthew as he again tries to figure out his path. Be with Ruth and Doug and the whole family as they worry and wonder. Lord, send your comfort to them and guide Matthew. Continue the healing of Cindy, Lord. Keep your healing touch on her, so that she can maybe get out sooner than the 3 weeks they told her she was going to have to be there. And Lord, be with Will and the doctors as they try to heal this sore. Be with all of us in our pains and our aches as we go through life. Guide us the right direction. And remind us to do no harm. Lord, be with the victims of the crash the other day and all the accidents, through all the detours and through all the driving that is going on as we start moving around again, as restrictions are lifted. Lord, we pray that everybody is calm. Everybody does not hurry. They take the time and they get to where they're going safely. Lord, we thank you for not only the spring season, but this graduation season as Sheree prepares to graduate and start a new chapter in her life. And all those who graduate from, whether it's preschool, kindergarten, middle school, high school, college, just be with them as they start a new chapter. Guide them to be the wonderful children that you know that we can all be. Remember all these things that we've brought before you, Lord. We lift up all the bad and we praise you for all the good. And we pray all these things along with the prayer that your Son taught us to pray. Our Thy kingdom come. Bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever, Lord. Amen. All right, as we join together, let's remember how hard it is to unintentionally do no harm. Let's try to work this week at doing no harm. Let's sing. Joy, joy, joy.
Joy, 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 down in my heart. Down in my heart.
in your heart and show that joy and happiness to all that you come in contact with.
Amen. Amen.
David.
Yes.
When you go down Chipping Road, which you can turn left or right on Prior?
Turn left on Prior.
Okay.
And it's the big building that looks like a wheel.
Okay.
Do you